Loaded up here in Michigan, headed to Panama City Beach, Florida. It is 1 piece, 142 pounds, 923 miles. Delivers. I just picked up. It is Tuesday morning, 7 a.m., and it delivers tomorrow morning at 8 a.m., so I got about 24 hours to get there, about a 15-hour drive, so we're going to get on the road and get it, man. So follow me to the beach, y'all. God bless y'all. Y'all be safe and have a great day. How's it going, man? I am on my way to Florida, like I said. Panama City, I guess. There's a difference between, there's a Panama Beach, and then there's a Panama City, I guess. But I'm delivering in Panama City. So, been talking, I must have talked it up, because I've been talking about, spending holidays there in Panama Beach. That's where I'm going to be going for holidays. But anyhow, I wanted to talk to y'all a little bit about mistakes. You know, you new drivers are thinking about coming out or whatever, researching the industry, whatever you're doing. I want to give you mistakes that I've made. I started out here in the over the road Expediting in June of 2020 last year. So a little bit over a year and a half now. About a year and a half now. Been researching it for over 2 years. I started researching about a year before I started out here. Did a lot of research and stuff. But the biggest mistake I've ever made is to think I know everything. And that's just my persona, man. That's just who I am. That's how I grew up, thinking I'm better than everybody. But I'm not. You're not. That's my biggest mistake, thinking I knew something. And not taking people's advice. And, you know, thinking I got this figured out. That type of thing, you know. That's me. That's who I am. I'll try to figure out stuff on my own. But that's where you go wrong, man. That's where I went wrong. And so you're always playing catch up, man. Me personally, I'm always playing catch up because I'm not listening to people. do, man, what you want to try to do is you want to try and get a couple people, maybe 2-3 people that you can, you know, take advice from, the basic people that can mentor you through this, you know, because that's what I did in the beginning. I got mentors, and I still got mentors that are helping me through, you know. But I've noticed for the past year and a half that my biggest mistakes is not doing what they tell me to do. Thinking I got it all figured out on my own, and I don't, man. And so that's why I'm continually playing catch up, man. And so right now I'm in a good spot. I believe I'm with a great fleet owner. I'm with a great company. And I'm doing okay. I'm doing okay for myself. I'm making my money, and I'm happy. I'm happy where I'm at right now. I know the goal is to eventually get my own van, but I mean, right now I'm happy. I'm happy where I'm at. Another mistake is not asking questions, even though you think you know the answer. Still run it by your mentors and ask them what they think, you know, tell them what you feel, you know. Them are just a few mistakes that I've made, and worrying about going home too much. That was a big mistake in the beginning. Right now, the company I work for, I'm going to my areas. I'm going to my area that I need to be at, you know. And so I'm not too concerned about it, you know. I'm out here, you know. Biggest mistake, another big mistake is worrying about, I mean, now, you know, like, you got the holidays coming up, right? And of course, we're going to want to go home, you know. You know, your main focus out here should be making money, saving money, and getting ahead. That's where we need to be at. And my mistakes that I've made is not saving money, blowing money, you know, downtime, going out and finding things instead of just chilling, still relaxing, you know, and just wait, you know. That's another mistake I made is spending too much money out here. You know, not saving money, you know. And so these are just a few mistakes that I've made that I want to try to help the new people coming out here doing this. Or if you're thinking about coming out here, these are the mistakes that I've made, you know. Because it's easy out here. It's easy out here to spend $100 or, you know, because you get caught somewhere on a Friday night and you're in a bad freight area and you're going to be basically there till Monday. And you know, me personally, I ain't gonna want to just sit in a van all weekend, so I'm gonna go find something to do. And you know, and so it's a mistake to go spend money, because you want to try to save money as much as you can, you know. Especially working for a fleet owner, you know, because you're limited on what you can do, you're limited on the money that you can make, you know. And so limited on where you can go. My fleet owner kind of basically lets me, you know, of course not anything outrageous, but he kind of lets me, you know, let me do what I want to do, you know. And that's how it should be. I mean, if I ever become a fleet owner, I mean, I'm not gonna micromanage my drivers. And a lot of these fleet owners, that's what they do. They micromanage you, you know. And sometimes when you're a new driver, like, I needed micromanagement when I first started, because I really didn't know what I was getting into. I was trying to learn. But just now, you know, showing you the mistakes I've made, you know, is not listening to your fleet owners and not listening to your, you know, people that are trying to help you get through this company or through this industry and help you grow in this industry. You know, I mean, if your plan is just to come out here, drive, and get a paycheck, then go for it, you know, whatever. But if you're
half a mile, keep left to stay on I-69 South.
If your plan is to get somewhere in this industry, then you have to listen to your, you got to listen to your mentors, your fleet owners, your company. Watch, you know, the videos. I don't know if you watch any other people.
Keep
videos,
left to stay on I-69 South.
But if you watch other people that's in the industry, you know, like, I don't know.
Continue on I-69 South for 93 miles.
I don't know if you know, like, Alan Paxton, Dell. Dell is Big D. Them two guys, man. Duncan with the Travels or whatever. Say, whatever. I forget his channel is called, but it's something Travels. You know, all these guys, if you're listening to these people, they got a lot of knowledge about the industry, you know. No, they don't know everything. I mean, there's a few of them out there that think they do know everything, but we only learn from our experience, you know. And so I'm just trying to give you my mistakes that I've made, and these mistakes, if you can jump over these mistakes and not make the same mistakes I made, you might get it more ahead within a year than I am. You know, I'm basically the exact same spot I am when I first started. You know, I am starting to work on my credit and trying to work out my credit, but you know, I'm still out here and I'm still, you know, when I'm down, I'm still going and blowing money, you know, and it's hard out here. It's hard out here not to spend money. And so that's, you know, that's two of my biggest mistakes, man, is not listening to my mentors and doing what they tell me to do and not saving money and not being patient, not blowing money, you know, on nothing, you know, nothing. So that's it, man. I just wanted to, you know, give you my insight on the mistakes I've made, and hopefully you don't make the same mistakes. I'm sure there's other mistakes that I'll think about, but I'm going to continue to drive, and I'm going through Indiana right now, but we got a long drive ahead of us, man. It is only 8:50 a.m. Eastern time, and so we got to drive along all day, all night, man. Not all night, but probably about midnight tonight, I'll be driving. Gotta try to get to Panama City by 8 o'clock tomorrow morning. That's when the drop is. So that's it, man. And just continue to follow me on this trip to the beach, baby. So be safe out there. God bless you guys.
Start the day yet. I just wanna stay, even if we run late. This morning, let's take our time. Everybody needs a break, right? Sometimes I know you for just an hour more. What's the rush?
Hey guys, how's it going, man? I want to keep touching on my mistakes I've made in Expedite. Another mistake I would, it's pretty dramatic mistake. And if you can avoid it at all costs, please do so. Another big mistake I made is letting my personal life get involved in my work, you know. My personal life got involved, and my first time out, when I was with Barrett, him like 6 months, and because of my personal life, I had to come off the road. And so, like, if you can avoid, you know, getting your personal life in under control, before you come out here, I highly recommend it. Now, of course, as you're out here, you know, life is still going on, you know, and just because you're running the road expediting, you know, doesn't mean that your life stops. You know what I mean? I think a lot of people in this industry, you know, especially like fleet owners that you may work for, you know, they have problems themselves. You know, they got issues. They got issues just like we got issues. But I mean, in people in general, I don't really think they don't put into consideration of, you know, your personal issues a lot of times. I'm not saying that I've worked for anybody like that. I'm just saying in general, you know. And so it's very important, man, that you get your personal life intact before you think about coming out here. Because being like I've said over and over again, man, being out here is it's a different ball game, man. It's a different ball game. Other than, you know, I got friends of mine that do local courier stuff, and sometimes they go out of town every now and again, you know. But being out here is totally different than that, man. You know, you're going from one state to the next out here, you know, and so you never know when you're gonna get close to home, you know. And so unless you tell dispatch you want to go that way, you know, I know after 3 or 4 weeks out here, you know, that's what I do. And so forth, man. You know, it's very important, man, that try to get your personal life in contact in the right order. You know what I mean? Because my personal life has gotten in the way so many times. Well, now, you know, now I'm with somebody that, you know, not saying that my fleet owner before didn't have my back. He did. It's just this time, it's just, you know, my fleet owner this time is more, he's more lenient on helping me out, you know what I'm saying, other than my old fleet owner was. You know what I mean? I'm not saying that one's better than the other. I'm just saying, like, you know, one is about, I think when it comes between my two, oh man, look at when what's the name of that, Allen's company, man, I don't know who it was, but, yeah, he had, I know it wasn't Allen, but, when it comes to the two fleet owners, man, you know, one of the, not saying they both are about making money, but I mean, one of them is more family oriented than the other one is. You know what I'm saying? Not saying that they're both family oriented, but one's more than the other. You know, and so I think it's very important that you think about what you know your family, you know, people that you care about, you know, that need you around, you know. And so me personally, man, I try to get there as much as I can, you know. If I'm out for 3 weeks, I'm gonna go home for the weekend. And that's all the fleet owner wants. You know, fleet owners, for the most part, any fleet owner that you work for is gonna say after 3 weeks, yes, go home. There's times I've been out here 4 or 5 weeks at a time, you know, that I didn't go home. And so, you know what I mean? It all depends on what, you know, if you can make it that way. If I make it that way, I usually try to stay a night or two, especially if it's the weekend, man. If you can get your personal life in order before you make this jump, it will help you a great deal. I'm finally getting my personal life in order, you know what I mean? And so I really think, you know, where I'm at now in life, man, things are going pretty good for me. And so I try my best not to involve my personal life in my business. And if I do, I try to, you have to deal with it on the weekends, you know. And so that's it, man. Just another nugget about, you know, mistakes out here, you know. We can sit all day long talk about, you know, the mistakes that we made. I'm just trying to give you my couple mistakes that I've made, man. And so we're still traveling. We're going through Kentucky right now, getting ready to hit the Kentucky-Tennessee border down here on Route 40. Just about 100 miles before I get to Nashville. And we're going to get through Nashville, and we're just going to head on through Alabama, down towards Florida that way, man. So like I said, we're going down to Panama City where we gotta deliver. I gotta be there 8 o'clock in the morning. So all right, y'all, God bless you guys, man. Y'all be safe out there, man. Hey guys, what's going on, man? Well, I was about right. I said I'd get here around midnight. That's what time I got here. Got delivered. It's 12:30 now. Well, it's Eastern time. I'm in Central time here in Panama City. It's Central time here. So it's only 11:30 here, but got delivered, and there's nothing here, you know, there ain't gonna be nothing here, so I'm just gonna go ahead and straight deadhead up out of here, and try to get up to Georgia. About a 4-hour drive, well, about a 3-hour drive to get to the border of Georgia. About a 5-hour drive to get to Atlanta. That's where all the freight is, but I'm gonna stop once I get into Georgia and probably sleep. Probably get to Georgia, the Georgia line around 3 a.m. Give me some sleep, sleep till about 8 or 9, and then, you know, I'll probably get something out of Georgia tomorrow. So, that's it, man. Was gonna go to the beach, but, hey, man, I'm trying to get the next load, you know. That's what we do out here, man. We go out to the next load. And, so, yeah, I came to Florida, but didn't get to see nothing because it's dark, but I gotta, in order to get me another load, I gotta get up to Georgia by morning time. So, I don't know, if I get tired, I'll probably pull over and go to sleep. I'll still be getting range right before the freight time starts, 9, 10, 11 o'clock. Try to get up to Georgia and get something. So that's it, man. My trip to Florida, man. So, all right, man, I'm gonna get off here, man. I'll talk to you guys in a little bit. God bless you guys. Y'all be safe out there now. Hey guys, what's going on, man? Yeah, you seen I deadheaded from Florida up to Georgia, made it to the house. So I got delivered and I dropped around midnight, like I said, and I tried to drive home, but it was like a 4.5-5 hour drive from home. And so I only drove about an hour, and then I pulled over at a Pilot and got some sleep and woke up about 7 o'clock and still drove up about 4 more hours and tried to get a load. Tried to get here by 10, 11 o'clock so I can get a load. And I did, wasn't able to get one. There was a bunch of people in front of me. But there was no reason for me to stay down in Florida because, you know, there wasn't nothing going on down there. They did call me yesterday afternoon, late in the afternoon, about 4:30, and I did get a load for today. Today's Thursday. I did get a load for today. It don't pick up till, it ain't due to pick up till 5 p.m., but after lunch, around 2, I'm going to drive. It's about 70 miles away from here. And so I'm going to drive up, probably get there about 3:30, 4 o'clock, and try to get it early. It's supposed to drop. It's 3 pieces, so I'm thinking I'm going to have a 3-skidder. I don't know. We'll see. I have not had a 3-skidder since I've been with XPO, but I'm all set up to get it because my bed raises up and down. So but I can it's going up to Illinois. It's kind of a shorty. It's only like 500 miles, and so you know, we're gonna get that taken care of. Hey man, if you have not subscribed to my channel, would you please subscribe to my channel? I'm a new expediter. Been in it a little under 2 years, and I just try to give my perspective on and my experiences on expediting. If you would, man, it'd help the channel to subscribe. I try to give out as many videos as possibly can, give my knowledge on what I feel and what I see in the expediting field. So just hit that subscribe, hit that bell, and you'll get the notifications when I upload these videos. If you like the video, give me a thumbs up. You know, if you're a hater, you can put the thumbs down. It's fine. It's all good this way, man. You know, fill up that comment section, give me comments and let me know what you think about what I have to say, or what, you know, things you see, or what things I do. And all that good stuff, man. Until the next video, man, Brother Mark's out. God bless you. And like always, man, be safe.